Hello, I'm Robin Whalley. Welcome to this third video in my mini-series looking at processing this image of millstones from the starting shot to the completed image. In the previous video, we looked at converting the RAW file using the Affinity Photo Develop persona into the image that you see on screen now. In this video, I'm going to actually look at converting the image using Nik Silver Efex Pro inside Affinity Photo into the black and white image. The first thing I want to do is actually duplicate the layer that I created in the Develop persona. This is the layer that I'm going to be working on in Nik Silver Efex Pro. The reason I'm doing this is because it leaves me with the original converted RAW file still in place in the main Affinity Photo window. Once I've created the duplicate layer, I can now select Nik Silver Efex Pro from the menu. Now, if you're unsure about how to install Nik Silver Efex Pro into Affinity, I do have a video that I've previously published on this subject. I'll put the details of that video in the video information below. Here we are then. We have the image open in Nik Silver Efex Pro, and we've got the default conversion. And to be honest, the default conversion isn't that bad for this image. I quite like it. Now, the things that I like about this is that there's plenty of detail here in the midtones, that the whites in the highlight areas are very bright, and we've also got detail in the shadows here in the millstones. So it's not a bad conversion. Now, the first thing I do when I'm converting in Nik Silver Efex Pro is I come down to these color adjustments here. This sets up the relationship between the colours in the image and how they're being converted to black and white. Once I've done that, I can then go back to the main area, which most people start with, and I can use those controls to shape the tones in the image that much better. I'll show you what I mean. Now, at the moment, there isn't a colour filter applied to this image because it's the default. If I select the yellow filter, you'll see that the yellows and greens in the image become that much brighter, where the blues become darker. The same will happen if I selected a green filter, or the orange, or the red. All that's happening is we're seeing slightly different response. Now, the opposite of those filters on the colour wheel is the blue filter. Now, watch what happens when I pick blue. It turns the strong greens in the image black, and it lightens the blues. So I'm going to actually start with this just to demonstrate how you can control the color responses in the image. But I'm going to reduce the strength of that filter just a little bit because it's too strong as it is. Now I can come down to the sensitivity. Now this controls how sensitive the different colors are to being converted to black and white. Now by sensitive I mean if you push one of these sliders up to the right, you'll see that it lightens areas of that colour, so the blues in the image are now brighter. Same would happen for cyans, although there isn't much cyan in the image. And the same would happen to yellow. Now, if you're not sure how the image is responding to the different sliders, it's always worthwhile just taking them and moving them left and right to see which areas produce a response. So at the moment, the reds are all gathered in the bottom part of the image here, and you can see them being lightened as I open up the red slider to increase it. Now I'm actually going to pull down the yellow slider just a bit, and the green slider I'm actually going to leave at a positive value, and just reduce down the yellows that bit further. Now what that's doing is it's allowing me to see the detail in this area that I liked before. We've also got detail in the highlights here. They're not too blown out at the moment, and that's because we're keeping the yellow quite low there. Maybe we can increase a little bit more the strength slider. I know it's actually not producing a good result, so we'll just keep that quite low. And now that I've created those adjustments, one of the things that I like to apply is a curve to that. And I'm going to use the curve to open up the midtones that little bit further but actually I don't want to affect the shadow areas too much, so I'm just going to pin that here. And that's creating a reasonably good look, although a little bit contrasty. If you look down here towards my histogram, you can see that at the moment I've not really got anything in the zero tone area of the image, so the very darkest blacks, there's only a few. The next area is, there's a little bit starting to creep in around here. And if I go to the whites, some of the whites are starting to clip just up here, but I'm not too worried about that either. So let's go back up to the top, and now we can use these sliders which control brightness, contrast and structure. And the one that I'm going to start with is the soft contrast. Now if I move this to the right, what it will do is it will lighten these white areas and darken the black areas, but in a very soft way. So you can see it there, and it tends to create a bit of a glowing effect or blown out effect. Now I don't want that at this stage. I'm more interested in creating a good conversion. So I'm going to pull the contrast, soft contrast, down to the left. And what it does is it opens up these shadow areas further when you do that, but it also draws down the highlight areas so you can see detail there. So I quite like that. Next one I'm going to use is this dynamic brightness slider. And that I can use to darken the image or lighten the image. I'm going to actually leave it more or less around the central area where it's not really having an effect. We may come back to it in a minute. Now once I've done those, I can look at creating some other effects in the image. Now one of the areas I could use is this amplify blacks. Now when I use this, what it does is it darkens the areas that are a little bit light, so it amplifies blacks in the brightest areas, and that allows the detail that's in there to be seen more clearly. Equally, if I amplify whites, it will open up the darker areas of the image to make them slightly lighter. Now that I've done that, I'm probably going to darken the image a little bit further with the dynamic brightness. Well, that looks reasonable at the moment. Now I'm going to also push up the mid-tone brightness just to make sure we've got detail in these shadow areas. At the moment it's looking like they're a little bit too dark in areas. And then I can actually look at adding in any structure. Now the millstones are largely in the mid-tone areas, and the highlights up here also need a bit of a structure boost. The final thing I'm going to do though is just protect the shadows now, and that will help stop these areas becoming too dark. And I can also protect the highlights here to make sure that those don't blow out to white. And as I've done all that, you can see the histogram has now been gathered into the center here. I don't have any clipping really in the highlights other than the very brightest area. And I don't have any clipping in the shadow areas either, which are around zone zero. There is some in zone one, but we can address any of these later. The final thing that I'm going to do now is actually pick a vignette and use the lens falloff vignette, possibly lens falloff 2 to start with. And I'll just adjust that slightly because I think it's a little bit too strong. I'm going to reduce the size of that vignette just to control it a little bit better, and I'm going to place the center of the vignette onto the millstones there. And that's created more or less the look I want. Actually, I may try the center here, and that actually, I prefer that look. It stops the millstones becoming too bright and this area darkening too much. So I like the effect that we've created there. If I compare it back to the original, that was the unadjusted, that's the adjusted. And we'll go forward with that in order to create the next stage of our editing process. I'll click OK, and that will apply the changes that I've made to the layer that I created at the start of the video. In the next video, I'll look at adding some special effects to this image in the shape of dodging and burning, and possibly a slight Orton effect. I hope you found this interesting. I'm Robin Whalley. You've been watching Lenscraft. I'll see you in the next video.